Tom Pace on the Talk of the Town. And as we're continuing on with our Shelter in a Box Emergency Preparedness Spotlight segment here in Shreveport, Louisiana, it's the middle of August right now. I mean, we are right in the middle of the dog days of summer. We'll probably break a record here just by Monday of next week. We'll probably have 48 days of heat in excess of 100 degrees. And do you know what that means? We've broken a record that was set all the way back in 1881. Another record that's being looked at in Louisiana is the record number of hurricanes that we've had over the past few years, disastrous hurricanes that has cost the state and the government millions and millions and billions of dollars for these people to get their lives back together. And today we're with Tony Russell from FEMA, who is here kind of overseeing some of the things that FEMA will be able to help with in Oklahoma's situation in the Shelter in a Box. And Tony, tell everybody exactly what your position is.
Hey, Tom, I am the FEMA Region 6 Administrator. And what that is in Region 6, it is the states of New Mexico, Oklahoma, Texas, Arkansas, and Louisiana.
So you look at all those states, and we all have one thing in common. We're right in the dead center of Tornado Alley and the hurricane zone in the Gulf of Mexico.
You know, Tom, not only that, we have fires, too. We have flooding. So within Region 6, you get the entire gambit of activity with disasters. So we got to be prepared at all times for everything.
And you mentioned fires, and we know a lot of Texas wildfires are happening here in Louisiana, major wildfires with all this excessive heat. And so you're kind of you're responsible in a way to cover some of that disaster.
Exactly. Also wildfires in Oklahoma. So there's fires everywhere in this region. And so our job is just to make sure that we're there if the governor requests our support.
We all know that FEMA hadn't always been the most fun name to hear, but I understand now you're trying to take a more proactive approach in terms of funding and making sure that things are handled better.
You know, in fact, you know, my job is every day to look at the most effective way for us to deliver the services to the state. And so I believe in doing things to make sure that we cut through the red tape, you know, that we make the process more streamlined. And so I think that what you have seen over the last 2 years is our ability to do exactly that. If you look at the recovery in Louisiana, for instance, you've seen that it's been a lot more progress that has been made. And that is what that whole mindset of don't be more focused on the process, look at the outcome. And the outcome is recovery.
As General Lanaray has said to me, it's not a matter of how you get it done. It's getting it done when it needs to be done.
Yes, as long as we do it legally, I'm for that, you know. And the whole goal is to have the perspective of outcome-based performance, not the process. You know, someone can, you know, cross every T and dot every I, and then not have anything to show for it when they're done.
That's exactly right.
We don't want to do that. We want to make sure the outcome is there, and that's what we're trying to do here.
Look at them as a kindler, gentler FEMA, and also supporting the states. And looking at the shelter in a box concept, it's not only good for Louisiana, it's great for Oklahoma because, you know, we're sister states, if you will. And for FEMA, it's a great opportunity because it's cost-saving. Is that it?
Tom, you know, it just makes sense, okay? It's common sense that is now put into practice. It makes sense as a philosophy. And the philosophy is, if somebody is going to be evacuated, have them as near to home as possible. If possible, don't send them out of state. Keep them in the state. It's good for them. It's good for their psyche. It's good for their well-being. And part two, it's more cost-effective. And so you put those two things together, you know, it makes just sound business practice for us to have shelter in a box. And I thank Oklahoma for being the ones to really forge this forward. And between Oklahoma and between Louisiana, we're here to put it into practice, to see all the planning, all the thought, all the concept. It looks good on paper, but now can it work? So we're here to do exactly that.
And then it was kind of an exercise over the past couple of days here in Shreveport. I understand you were having a regional meeting as well about the same time.
Yes, we're having it's called a Regional Advisory Council meeting. And what that is basically is from all of the five states, and they send representatives who are basically my eyes and ears to what's going on in the region. And they bring to me different concepts, different concerns, and nothing is too big or too small. I want to know what's going on and how I can be value added. And that's their job. Their job is to tell me things that we can do better, things that we can change, go left, go right, and that's what they do.
They're your quarterbacks, and he is the coach. And I would say congratulations to you, Tony Russell. You're doing a great job. We love the fact that FEMA is working hand in hand with all of these emergency organizations. We look forward to your continued support. And by the way, is this kind of a pilot program? Is this currently being done somewhere else?
No, it's the first. And this is the first one, and it's going to be something that's going to catch on. The idea that's been forged by Oklahoma and the partnership with Louisiana is going to be something that it makes too much common sense not to catch on. And I think that as we continue on to make the process even better, folks are going to see this is the way to go for the future.
And that is the wave of the future, people helping people. Shelter in a box. Thanks to Oklahoma. Thanks to the Louisiana folks for helping with all those evacuees that might be coming up north from South Louisiana. I'm Tom Pace. Another emergency preparedness report on the Talk of the Town.